made my choice, Addy. I'm calling her the Jackdaw. A sly bird I loved as a child back in Swansea.
A dark little creature, no?
Did it rub you wrong when I took this brig as mine own?
It was the sort of rub I have learned to endure, sailing among faces of such fairness.
It's true. Most of these men wouldn't accept you as a captain. So what fair role would complement such unfairness?
I'll be your quartermaster. Nothing less.
All right. And as quartermaster, have you any immediate counsel for this Tyro captain?
Rest and repast would do us good before Nassau. Water for drinking. Hunting for food and repairs.
Well reasoned, sir. Hunting, it shall be. You'll find a decent place to drop anchor. I spied a few items in the hold earlier. Powder and a few pistols. I think I'll fashion a second holster if I can.
It's a good start.
One you find laughable.
Could we talk a moment about the condition of the ship?
What's the trouble?
I had a walk about the gun deck this morning, and couldn't stand for what I saw. A clutter of linstocks heaped like tinder, and one with a slow match, still burning.
Christ.
And just nearby, two barrels of gunpowder, closer than man and wife. Fit to explode at the touch of a spark.
We'll stow ours good and proper.
As for the cannons, they might as well be tossed. Clogs touch holes in need of scraping, corrosion on the bodies, barrel swabs as naked as knives, and breech ropes so rotted, I could use them for knitting yarn. The short of it is, we need good equipment kept in fine condition. But we cannot win every battle with snares and shouts. So worry about your own armaments when it suits you. But don't forget about your Jackdaw as well.
No, indeed. We'll make it a point to keep this ship and its crew in fine condition.
Ahoy, Captain. Find what you need.
My needs and wants are oceans apart, mate. But I did fashion myself a new holster. All I need now is a pistol to lie in it.
Yeah. Taken from the holds, just as you said.
A little more than a blowpipe. But it'll do. So, are we rested? Or should we idle a while longer?
Best way anchor. I think the crew is itching to reach civilization.
You'll find no civilization in Nassau. But it's a fine place to be merry all the same.
Captain Queernabs, tell me I'm under arrest.
Tell me!
Them your breads.
Fly away, boyo! Back to your master!
Aye. We was privateers together before the wars ended. I'll see you ashore.
My God, you're a sight for salty eyes. Come you in and have a drink.
Morning, all.
Ahoy, Kenway. Who's this?
Adewale, the Jackdaw's quartermaster.
Jackdaw.
You named your brig after a poxy bird.
Ade, these lads are the better part of our growing confederacy here. Ed Thatch, Ben Hornigold, James Kidd.
You let him carry a pistol, do you?
Peace, Ben. Ade saved my life. And now we're looking to find a crew to fill out the rest of my ship.
Well, there are scores of capable men abound. But use caution. A shipload of the King's sailors showed up before night back, causing trouble and knocking about like they own the place.
Right. I'll see you I can muster.
Any men you find to the Jackdaw, I put them to work.
Cheers, Ade.
Possibly need. Gathered here for you, good folks.
these new...
Let me out of...
Look, my patience is just a bit done, as are you. Ease to your bloody orders.
Thanks. Kenway, isn't it? I'm with you.
There, I'll wager.
Let me out of...
I'm leaving. I'm done.
You, Catamite. Thanks. Kenway, isn't it? I'm with you.
Whatever I may have done, spare me, friend.
Kenway, come fast! There's soldiers of Captain Anne and we need to hang him!
Pays the blood of many innocents on...
I think I can hit him! I've got a clear shot!
Bless your timely breeches, Kenway.
Now you'll want to sail somewhere rich with plunder.
Have you heard of a place called the Observatory?
Aye. It's an old legend, like El Dorado or the Fountain of Youth.
What have you heard?
It's meant to be a temple or a tomb, hiding a treasure of some kind.
That's it. See here.
Oh, rot. It's fairy stories you prefer to gold, is it?
It's worth more than gold, Thatch. 10,000 times above what we could pull off any Spanish ship.
Robbing the king to pay his paupers is how we earn our keep here, lad. It ain't a fortune. It's a fantasy.
Kenway.
Not a bad-looking tinderbox you got there.
You sound a bit green, horny gold. Is it envy? Is mine bigger than yours?
No, I reckon it's this Jamaican funk. I prefer the Spanish stuff. So, you've got yourself a fancy brig now. Fine. Well, I'm gonna teach you how to sail all right. And how to take a prize the proper way. Thatch, we'll catch you up at the old fishing village.
Aye.
Where's your helmsman, Kenway?
I take pride in piloting my own ships, Ben. Keeps me alert.
Let's make some headway, shall we?
I've no need for schooling. How many prizes did we take together as privateers?
There's a chasm of difference between joining a raid and captaining one. We're looking out for merchants, boys! Them that's fat with cargo! Find us a schooner with that spyglass, Kenway. You'll get yourself a glimpse of what sort of cargo they're shipping and a general idea of their toughness. You won't find nothing squinting into the sun like that. Use your glass.
I asked this maid out for a walk, that we might have some private time. I go, Robin, with you, fair maid.
There's a prize worth taking.
Good. Take us in close. After you subdue a province, project authority. Demand respect that you would never give yourself. This weaves a spell. Soft minds. For your victims must always have in the back of their minds the uneasy idea that you could snap at any moment and unseam them from prick to sternum.
Then take fair warning, boys, from me. Well, what I do say. So take a warning, boys, from me. With other men's wives, don't make too free. I'll go no more a roving with two fair maids.
Fire what cannons you will, and land a few strikes if you must. But for God's sake, don't sink. It's no fun to go cargo out of the sea. Although it can be done. She's disabled now and taking on a decent amount of water. So keep your cannons quiet. Take care not to sink her.
Tengo un buen día, señor.
I am Captain Hornigold, and this is my crew. We're sailors like yourselves, but quite unlike in our purpose. For we intend to take all that you own. Yet no harm shall befall any man so long as he remains at ease. Is that clear?
No me mate, señor. Tengo familia. Se lo suplico.
Anyone speak English? English?
Little bit.
Tell your friends we're stealing your goods, and we won't hurt nobody if everyone stays as still as a sandbar. You got that?
Please to repeat.
Oh, for fuck's sake. Lock him in the hold and take everything that isn't nailed down.
Feeling sailing about with this much stolen cargo.
Get used to it. We'll need to take a few more prizes to make this a profitable day.
Let's catch some wind, lads.
Down that ship there.
Loose all, let's move. Loose all, party line.
Wait for a day, wait for a day, wait for a day, then we get our pay. She was built in Roman times, held together with bits of twine.
Good take today, Kenway. Half a dozen scores of that size and you'll be set for a year. And let's sell this cargo and fix up your jackdaw with a few more trinkets.
Sod it, ye. I'm looking for a prize that'll set me up for life. The King of the West Indies, eh?
We came to Nassau to get away from the likes of kings.
Well, I'll be a man of property and promise anyway.
Jesus, let that dream go, lad. Nassau is the place to be. Not England.
Do you ever dream of the big score? A ship so full of gold and silver, you just split it and sail home.
Sure, but it's only a dream. Every man hopes to find a dozen chests of gold with no owners. They're as rare as an honest king.
Johnny Poker, come rock and roll me over. To me, Johnny Poker, do. Oh, to me, Johnny Poker, the skip on is a rover. To me, Johnny Poker, do. Oh, to me, Johnny Poker, the Mickey's never sober. To me, Johnny Poker, do. Oh, to me, Johnny
Poker. Sally Brown, she's the gal for me, boys.
Oh, boys, go, boys, go.
As I rolled out one morning, away.
Now's all but me!
Keep
chilling!
Hey!
¿Puedo ayudarlo?
Bad take today. Keep this up and Nassau will be the first city where men and women may live as God made them. Easy and free. All it takes is a few drops of blood, sweat, and a swatch of cloth.
We fly no colors out here. But praise the lack of them. So let the black flag signal nothing but your allegiance to man's natural freedoms. This one's yours. Fly it proud.
I will.
A hand over the docket, I lend you. If we're to keep our republic afloat, we'll need guns as well as gold.
That means attacking the navy.
So long as they're flying King Philip's colors, we'll not offend our own monarch. As you've likely seen, the number of merchants roving these waters is 80 the number of military ships.
Aye, easy purchase, but in small doses.
Right. So to lure the navy out of hiding, it's best to cause a bit of mischief.
Catch a few small fish to attract the big ones.
That's right. So plunder and pillage as you see fit, Captain Kenway.
Military class brig on the horizon!
Good eye, man. Are you ready for this, Kenway? She won't go down without an honest fight.
Who's up for taking that brig, lads? Shout aye! That's a sound I like to hear. Pipe to quarters! All hands to cannon!
Careful around the navy. They're as likely to ram you as fire a broadside.
Let's test those powder barrels against them, shall we?
Fine, good thinking.
Ready, sir!
Fire!
Put a shot right through there!
Fire!
Fire! Get in there, sir! That'll wipe them out!
Fire!
As much sand as you can! Take a shot right there, sir!
Fire!
taste of British steel.
That was a rumble, by God. How do we fare?
A fine purchase, no mistake. Now I think it's time to lay low and drive our way back to secrecy.
Agreed. So, how do we get rid of this notoriety and stir that?
Money, my boy. Well-placed bribe to the right government official. See the military after your tail.
Right, let's do that. I'll need to meet these good Samaritans at some point.
Smart thinking.
It's a prank!
Oh,
to the top!
Rest your bolts! We're coming together!
As much sail as you can! Shorten sail! Get off the squall!
Bring it all sail! Gammon tight!
To vanish, friend.
Right. Now let me work my magic.
You're a wonder, Kenway. You've a knack for this kind of work.
It ain't work if you love it.
Ah!
But I ain't doing this forever, lads. Only until I get enough coin to buy some land and influence back home.
Jesus, will you listen to your tripe? Still dreaming on about that strumpet back in England when you could have any better you wanted here and now.
Ah, such lofty goals for you gents. And here I thought I was in the company of scoundrels. Fine purchase today. What's the crew's mood?
All smiles and no teeth. And there's a few talking about meeting with Master Kidd to steal from a nearby plantation.
Plantation? That's ambitious.
Profitable too, if we can manage it.
Aye. It's a good idea.
Half sails.
Loose all, let's move.
Aloft, lads. Check those royals. I think we're clear, sir.
Douse all but me.
Ease the spanker! Hold down!
Fall all!
Fall! Fall for all your worth!
Got salt in himself!
Why, look! It's the bastard son of the late William Kidd. Still a mere boy, and yet... 10 times the demon his father was.
Fancy seeing you here, Kenway. Still looking sleek and mean. Did you steal that costume from a dandy in Havana?
No, sir. I found this on a corpse. One that was walking about and talking shite to my face only moments before.
Huh.
That's all. What's this I hear about a planned raid on a plantation? Not keeping secrets from me, are you?
Not very well. Every day, schooners packed with sugar sail past, coming from plantations nearby. Most times they stop here, sell off a few crates. There's one man visiting today that had earned you a fine profit. So if you'd like to rob his plantation, I'll point him out.
I would. Is it a Mr. Beckford that owns this plantation?
That's the man. He owns dozens round these islands. And he's bloody rich.
Just the sort I like to see robbed.
His agent is around here somewhere. Find and follow him, and he'll lead you straight to your prize.
Despite the waywardness of your enterprise here, I understand that you are men of discernment. Just now, we came to quite an understanding.
As you see, sir.
All up and unfurl, boys. We're going home.
You have the look of a man crafting a bold idea. A look I've seen before.
You mark well, Annie. I've just overheard one of the Beckford's men talking grandly about his plantation and all the cargo he's keeping there, and it gave me the idea that I might take these goods off him and sell them off for a better price than he'd ever ask.
Ah, a man of vision. I like this idea.
Let's ride this wall!
We must tread lightly! These waters are well guarded, sir!
Hold at it. There's trouble afoot.
I see them.
Sir, to the starboard! Floating booty there for the taking, sir!
man's working for Peter Beckford's people. Do you know them? The Beckfords and their sugar empire.
Aye. The Beckfords and the Draxes. I never worked their plantations, but I knew their names from hearing other men curse them.
But you worked a plantation, no?
A modest one, aye. As a striker in the boiling house.
Boiling house? Was it water they boiled, or something else?
Cane juices. It's a hard process making sugar. Dangerous. Must be why it fetches such a dear price.
What's it like, toiling on a plantation day and night?
Well, with the cane sugar cut and harvested, it's run between two metal rollers and crush the juice from the plant. After collecting the juice, it was time to boil away the waters from the sugar. This we did in Thatcher's Mill. Let me tell you, brother, boiling sugar is near the hottest thing on earth. Just a touch on the skin will stick like birdlime and burn on, leaving a terrible scar.
Jesus.
Fall weather there, Captain!
It's a risk to anchor too close. The soldiers roving the plantation would catch us for sure.
Drop here then and sneak ashore. We'll look after the jackal.
Such disarray.
Bit of a do, sir, that's all. It's Wilmington's birthday.
And you saw fit to get pickled on duty.
No bother, sir. We had everything sorted.
We'll soon see, won't we? For you must double the watch this evening.
Double, sir? Whatever for?
I believe I was followed here, young man. By pilots, if my eyes on me. Though the ship was uncommonly large for such rascals. Certainly wasn't slavers, though. Not a ship that size. In any case, double the watch. And keep your damned eyes wide for anything suspicious. You up there! Look alive, man!
Apologies, sir. I'll keep my eyes peeled.
For God's sake, what the hell is going on here today? How do you suppose you'll be able to ring that alarm if you're piss drunk and barely able to stand?
Want to get to our point.
Give it up! He slithered away back in his hole.
Alarm!
Rouse yourselves, you dullards!
What was that, John?
I'd like to speak to the man in charge here. I require entrance to the warehouse. Which of you dogs has the key to the warehouse, huh? Is there no one sober here? Fetch me the warehouse key, if you please.
God damn it. Someone find me the key!
Ah, damn the kid! He's gotten away!
Too much action.
king.
I don't want any part of this. Stop it.
I'm leaving.
There's not.
Here's to our pirate republic, lads. We're prosperous and free and out of the reach of kings, clergy, and debt collectors.
Near 500 men now pledge their allegiance to the brethren of the coast in Nassau. Not a bad number.
True. Yet we lack sturdy defenses. If the king were to attack the town, he'd trample us.
Then let us find the observatory. If it does what these Templars claim, we'll be unbeatable.
Not that twaddle again, Kenway. It's a story for schoolboys. I mean, proper defenses. Steal a galleon, shift all the guns to one side. Could make a nice ornament for one of our harbors.
It will not be easy to steal a full Spanish galleon. Have you one in mind?
I do, sir. And I'll show you. She's a fussock, she is. Fat and slow.
Her jackdaw handles knives. Pinched her from the Spanish, was it?
Aye. In the midst of a hurricane.
Just before the treasure fleet was smashed against the shore.
Was the haul aboard as rich as men are saying?
1,000 times that. I reckon £1,000,000 worth of reals was sunk that day.
Devil love a hurricane. Might have a dive there one day. See what we can rummage up.
Diving them wrecks would be a nice change of pace for us. No need for violent actions against merchants and such.
Well. That's some soft talk coming from a pirate. And as it happens, I mostly agree. We'll save the clashing of cutlasses for the military. And them that get in our way. Easy as she goes. No telling what you may find out here.
Like staring through a waterfall.
Don't soil your breeches, lads. I got this.
We'll strike when fortune favors us.
And the cover of darkness, most likely.
Ah, you may come to that.
Trim the yards off the wind!
Mainmast, bring in the top halyards! Pull!
Hold sail! She'll take it!
Loose all! Party-like!
Charles, he's as reckless as they come.
An old friend of yours?
Not a man I'd call a friend. But we've been doing this kind of work for so long, I can't help but respect.
sailing for that island.
I know the place. A natural stronghold used by a French captain named Ducasse.
Julian Ducasse, the Templar.
Name's right. Didn't know he had a title.
I know the man. And if he sees my ship, he'll know it from his time in Havana, meaning he may wonder at who's sailing her now. I can't risk that.
And I don't want to lose that galleon. Let's think on't. And maybe wait till it's dark before hopping aboard.
Gentlemen, as is custom among our kind, we do not plunge headlong into folly on the orders of a single madman, but act according to our own collective madness. The object of our attention is a square-rigged galleon, and we want her for the advantage she'll bring Nassau. So I'll put it to the vote. All those in favor of storming this cove and taking this ship, stomp and shout aye!
Aye!
Those who oppose, whimper nay!
Aye!
Never was the King's Council so unified.
Alto!
The last time we will see land for a month.
Remember the gift you gave me? Well, it answers just fine.
Fils de putain! As bold as a musket ball, and still half as sharp!
I'm sorry about this, mate, but I can't risk you telling your Templar friends about me still kicking around.
I pity you, Boucanier. After all you have seen, after all we showed you of our order, still you embrace the life of an ignorant and aimless rogue!
What's this?
Is petty larceny the extent of your ambition? Have you no mind to comprehend the scope of ours? All the empires on Earth, abolished, a free and open world, without parasites like you! Que l'enfer que tu trouveras soit le fruit de ton insouciance.
The cove is ours!